Aboard, ladies and gentlemen. It is Saturday, November 19th, 2016. Welcome, Lakes Area Community Television. Thomas Glenn sitting here at the Forest Lake Sports Center on this chilly Saturday night, bringing you some Lakers hockey. Forest Lake hosting the Steele County Blades. This is game number one in a six-game series between these two teams. They will meet again tomorrow at 5:30. But right now, face-off inside of the Blade zone and sent into the Lakers zone, where the Lakers will attempt to regroup it here. Puck is turned over along the near boards, picked up inside of the neutral zone by number 21, Stewart, for the Lakers, has a man out front. Decides to take the shot off of the post, just missing wide left. Play will continue. Puck picked up inside of the neutral zone. Last touch by number 25 for Steele County. It's number four, Hansen, for the Lakers will hand it off. That pass is picked off by number 29 for the Blades. It's now Steele County moving it around inside of the Lakers zone. 19 minutes left to play here in period number one. Score still tied at 0-0. Steele County able to hold the zone at the blue line. Number 18 will fire it in. Now Forest Lake on the move inside of the neutral zone, carried in by number 13 for the Lakers. Sends it out front. Unfortunately, nobody home. Forest Lake able to hold the zone with a shot on net. And now a little bit of extracurricular activities going on in front of the Steele County net. Nothing too serious. Play is broken up and we'll have a face-off inside of the Steele County zone. Again, happy, I almost called it November, it's Movember. Already 13 years now after getting its official launch back in 2003 to help spread awareness of men's health as well as raise money to help combat cancer and a list of other health-related issues. The Movember Foundation now raises over $21 million yearly, just an absolute great cause. It looks like the face-off is being moved on down to the Lakers zone for whatever reason. Well, I guess a penalty would do it, a two-minute minor being assessed to Forest Lake. And this is going to bring out the Laker penalty kill early in period number one, 18:33. Left to go as the Blades will get a crack at their first power play here against Forest Lake in the 2016 season. There we go, it's up on the board, it's official. That is number 12 for Forest Lake being assessed a two-minute minor, like I said. Puck is spit out. This could be a shorthanded opportunity for Forest Lake. They do have numbers. A potential 2-on-1 is broken up. Play picked up inside of the neutral zone. Number 7 for Forest Lake. And play is picked up along the near side boards inside of the Lakers zone. Forest Lake with possession. That's number 4, Hansen. And he will gently slide it into the Blade zone. Now a minute 26 left to go in power play number one for the visiting Steele County Blades. Inside of the neutral zone, past number 16. That shot is blocked. Into the corner, shot taken by number 25. That goes wide right. Nice job by number 20 on the blue line for Steele County to hold the zone. Jumped up, grabbing that puck out of midair. Fortunately for the Lakers, they are eventually able to clear it. Now 53 left to go in power play number one for the Blades. An opportunity out front for Steele County. Shot taken by number nine. Not the best of shots. Wide right. Looks like the puck left the stick before he was even looking at his target. That's going to be a clear for Forest Lake. Steele County looking to regroup up a skater for another 24 seconds. Other than a couple of shots on net, nothing too serious here for Forest Lake. Another clear. This might give the Blades one more opportunity as the clock now down to 6 seconds. Picked up by Forest Lake, and that should do it for the Lakers. Penalty kill. Forest Lake back to full strength. Puck picked up inside of the neutral zone. Forest Lake forced to regroup. Nearly picked off by number 19 for Steele County. As number 14 for Forest Lake will carry it inside of the Blade zone. Steele County forced to regroup deep inside of their own zone. A nice move by number 14 for Forest Lake. Quick shot taken, that's number 14. That goes wide right. Held inside the Forest Lake zone as a D step up. Puck sent out front, unfortunately nobody home. A quick touch there by number three for the Lakers, and eventually the net comes off of its moorings. And that's gonna lead to a face-off inside the Steele County zone. 15:47 left to play here in period number one. Again, you're watching Lakes Area Community Television. This is Thomas Glenn. Welcome aboard for those of you just joining us. It is a Saturday, a cold one, November 19th, 2016. This is game number one between the Forest Lake Lakers and the Steele County Blades. The Blades almost benefiting from a breakaway there as the puck slides off of the backhand opportunity and misses wide left. The Lakers now forced to regroup deep inside of their own zone. Puck carried out to the neutral. Nice move, number 21 for the Lakers with the opportunity. Nice poke check by the Steele County goaltender. Steele County able to clear the zone. Lakers send it right back in. Played along the near boards. Cross ice pass is broken up by the official of all people. Be interesting to see where they spot the faceoff here. Should be outside in, yeah, there we go. Inside of the neutral zone, 14:53. Still a scoreless game here at the Forest Lake Sports Center. Forest Lake Lakers hosting the Steele County Blades. As Steele County will send it deep into Laker territory. Puck is scooped up by the Laker goaltender. That's number one, Jesse Heiss. That will result in a faceoff inside of the Lakers zone, 0-0. Lallier on the draw for Forest Lake, team captain. Faceoff is won by the Lakers, sent back around. A bad hop jumps over the stick of number 20, a defenseman for Steele County. Cross ice pass. And that play is broken up by the Lakers as they will now attempt to move it outside of the neutral zone. They are successful. Steele County now on the move. Number five will carry it in. Make the dump, 14:08 left to go in period number one. As that puck trickles back into the Blades territory, now back inside of the neutral zone. A big hit put on by number 14 of Forest Lake, and I think that they might be throwing him an elbow penalty. Number 14, that's Curtis Wilson. Wilson out of Blaine, Minnesota, and it looks like we have an injury out on the ice. And with that injury, I think this would be an opportunity for station identification. Don't go anywhere. Plenty of hockey left to play out here at the Forest Lake Sports Center. 13:56 left to go here in period number one.
Sometimes all it takes to be a dad is remembering how to be a kid again. Take time to be a dad today.
Welcome back to Laker hockey, period number one, back underway after that injury. Number two, Antonio Najara for the Blades, able to get up under his own power. Certainly we wish him the best. Hopefully he will be okay. Lakers on the move. They do have numbers, a 3-on-2, number 26. Well, that's number 28. Nice save by the Blades goaltender. Forest Lake able to hold the zone. Looking for opportunities, picked up by the defender for Steele County. Held in by Hansen. And that is dumped into the Lakers zone. Played along the near boards. Number 23 with a couple of nifty moves. Steele County holds the zone. Puck played along the near corner. Both teams still scrambling for possession as it pops up out of nowhere. Forest Lake will make a change as the puck is sent into the Blade zone. 12:46 left to go here in period number one. A nice steal there by number 12 for Forest Lake. Whiffed on the shot just around the high slot area. An excellent place to take a shot too. It's unfortunate, sent back into the Blade zone as they look for a cross-ice pass that's gonna trickle all the way down into the Lakers zone. Now played along the near boards. Forest Lake looking to carry it out. They do. Now inside of the neutral zone. Offsides is waved off. And that's going to cross over. Forest Lake will be forced to regroup inside of the neutral. Steele County will send it out front. A nice block put on by number 19 as that shot never had a chance to reach its target. Now played along the near board, sent behind the Laker goaltender. Now played along the far boards. Play broken up by number 19 for Forest Lake as they carry it into the neutral zone where it's picked up by number 29 for the Blades. Send it around the near side boards as they look to carry it outside of the zone. They are able to and are now on the move. Nope, never mind. Pick back up inside of the neutral zone. Shot taken over the head of Heiss and into the near side corner. Sent back to the blue line of Steele County. Forest Lake is able to break it up as they will now regroup with 10:47 left to play in the first period. Score still tied 0-0. Again, this is the first meeting between these two teams here in the 2016 season. Five more games left to play out between these two. One of them will take place tomorrow right back here at the Forest Lake Sports Center, and that is at 5:30. Steele County now with possession as they carry it inside of the neutral zone. Number 14. A nice opportunity. He decides to go with the backhand. And no problem for the Forest Lake goaltender, Jesse Heitz. To see that, that is covered up. 10-11 left to play out here in period number one. Faceoff inside of the Lakers zone. Played by Heiss. Hansen with the touch. Steele Coney able to hold the zone. Forest Lake looking to break out. They do. A 2-on-3 is setting up. Shot taken by number 28. Tough angled shot. Goaltender will pick that up, and that's going to lead to a faceoff inside the Steele Coney zone. 9:49. Left up there on the clock here in period number one. Again, you're watching Lakes Area Community Television Saturday Night Hockey here at the Forest Lake Sports Center. Team captain number 7, Lollier, on the draw for Forest Lake. Steele Coney able to win the draw. Forest Lake somehow manages to squeeze a shot out, hits the side of the net, and the Blades look to carry it out. Puck now played along the far boards. Cycled to number 3. Nice cut. Sends it back around. And that is flipped outside of the Forest Lake zone. Nearly held in by number 28. And what a hit put on by number 19 for Forest Lake. And an open ice, that's Joe Broffy. Back to the blue line. Shot taken by number 29. There's another backhand by number 9. That misses wide left. Forest Lake struggling to carry the puck outside of their zone. Back to the blue line, held in by number 28. Heiss lost sight of that one. Fortunately, it went right for his chest. And out of nowhere, Steele Coney is absolutely peppering. Forest Lake goaltender, another shot on net. Back to the blue line, number 5 will hold it, and that one is deflected out of play. But Forest Lake needs to do something different here as they are absolutely struggling to move the puck outside of their own zone. 8:16 left to go here in the first period. Score still tied 0-0. Each team with 8 shots on net. Steele Coney will win the faceoff inside of the Lakers zone. Both teams kind of scrambling for possession. Nice poke check there by goaltender Jesse Heiss. Hope I'm saying that right. There's an opportunity out front for the Blades. Covered up by the Laker goaltender. That's going to lead to another faceoff inside Forest Lake territory. There we go, some Johnny Cash. Lakers win the draw as they attempt to cycle it. It's held into the zone by number 5 for Steele Coney. They will send it right back into the Lakers zone where it's played along the near boards. Nearly deflects into the Laker net. Another big shot taken from the point by Steele Coney. That has been their game plan here as of early. Forest Lake able to clear only to the neutral zone where it's picked right back up by Steele Coney. And they have been almost moving the puck around at will here early in period number one. 14 looks for an opportunity. A nice spin move, ends up with a backhand shot. Heiss, no problem. And now it's Forest Lake on the move. Number 16. Sends it back to the blue line. That shot will miss wide right. Held in by number 3 for Forest Lake. Both teams scrambling for possession along the near side, inside of the Blade zone. I don't think it's going anywhere soon. And there it goes. He lost his stick, still moves with the skates. We have a whistle. Looks like that's going to give Steele County power play number two here in period number one, as the Lakers are going to have to bring out the penalty kill once again. Steele County 0-for-1 on the power play thus far as they get another opportunity. 2-minute minor being assessed. I believe it's slashing. We'll find out here shortly. 2-minute slashing. Face off inside of the Blade zone. One by Steele County. Shot taken from the blue line by number 3 is deflected. And will bounce over the goaltender's head. Forest Lake unable to clear it. Lawley are able to get a stick on it. We'll send it all the way down. Now 1:40 remaining in the second power play for Steele County. Nice touch again by Lawlier to break up that play. Keep on. Why is icing waved off? Cross ice pass to number 29 as number 14 will head to the bench and get some fresh legs out there on the ice. Puck played along the far side of the boards as they kick it back to the blue line. Hesitates on the shot, still able to hold the zone. Now it's held up just inside of the blue line there. Cross ice pass to number 9 from the high slot. Nice drop pass, and Forest Lake able to clear it now. 45 seconds remaining in power play number 2 for the Blades. Forgot something, buddy. Steele County on the move with the cross ice pass. Ends up inside of the Lakers zone, and Forest Lake will send her on back down. And that should kill the rest of the penalty, as there is now just 10 seconds remaining. Now 8-7. Cross ice pass behind them. Nice poke check by number 26. The Lakers now back to full strength as they have now killed 2 straight penalty kills. Very nice. Steele County still on the move. Like I said, just doing an excellent job of moving the puck around and using their D-men. Another shot back from the point. And another penalty. Looks like we're going to have a cross-checking. And that's going to be assessed to Forest Lake yet again. Penalty number 3. Let's hope the third time is not a charm for Steele County. 0-for-2 thus far on the power play. Let's hope that Laker penalty kill can kill off yet another penalty. Face off inside of the Lakers zone. Won by Steele County. Sent back to the blue line. Number 28 will send it back to number 3. Uses a skate to keep it in. That shot taken wide left. Puck played along the far boards inside of the Lakers zone. Forest Lake down a skater for another 1:36. Sent out front. Looked like it went off the shin of one of the defenders. And that puck's going to roll out to the neutral zone. That shot blocked before it has a chance to reach the net. Steele County doing a nice job again, moving the puck around. Back to the blue line, number 5, looking for the tip out front, nearly gets it. Oh, what's it going to do? passes it off back to the blue line. That play is broken up, and Forest Lake with a shorthanded opportunity, number 14. No penalty is called. Touche, a nice job by the defenders of Steel County to get back in time to break it up and avoid any penalty in doing so. Now just 35 seconds remaining in the Steel County power play. This penalty kill much more effective for Forest Lake than we've seen in the first two. Inside of the Lakers zone, gloved out of the air by number 13. Back to the blue line, number 29. Takes a shot. Another save by Heiss. Kicked into the corner. Now just 5 seconds remaining. Back to the blue line, number 18, with a quick wrister. And I believe it was deflected before it reached the back of the net. Doesn't make a huge difference. It's still a goal. And a power play goal at that for Steel County. So the third time looks like is a charm if they do credit him with the power play goal. I know it was close. The clock now shows full strength. Let's see what they decide to give him. Well, they're going to give the goalie, or they're going to give the goal to number 18. So apparently there was no deflection, or if there was, it was missed by the officiating crew. Either way, Steel County with a one-goal lead. 1:42 left to play here in period number one. Heiss unable to glove that. Now played along the near side of the boards. Steel County, wow, just an amazing job holding that blue line. You'd think it was life or death for them. Puck picked up inside of the neutral zone, sent deep into the Blades territory. Puck just chilling behind the Steel County net. Blades able to carry it out of their zone as they dump it into the Lakers. For exchange, some fresh legs. Daly with the touch. Picked up by number 29, one-on-one. Woo! Just missing wide right again. A rocket of a shot taken by number 16. Right around that high slot area. Nice move there, fortunately for the Lakers. They play the body and not the puck. Play is broken up. Sent in to the Blade zone. Now played along the near side of the boards. Carried into the Lakers zone by number 14. Now it's Forest Lake on the move. A 3-on-3. That's broken up immediately. Steel County will send her on down, as that's going to wrap up the first period. Pretty evenly matched throughout, but Steel County will walk away with a one-goal lead. But I recommend you stick around. Plenty of hockey yet to come here at the Forest Lake Sports Center. Again, this is Thomas Glenn with Lakes Area Community Television. And after one period of play, it's Steel County 1, Forest Lake 0.
Adventure can be found anywhere, but the best place to start is in the forest.
I spy something beginning with S.
Snow?
No.
Snow-covered trees?
Nothing to do with snow.
Head outside to discover incredible animals and beautiful plants that come together to create an unforgettable adventure.
Wow.
So grab your loved ones.
Don't even.
And explore a world of possibilities.
Come on, this way.
Visit discovertheforest.org to find the closest forest or park to you.
Welcome back to the Force Lake Sports Center. Force Lake Laker hockey in progress, hosting the Steele County Blades. Period number two just about to get underway here. Force Lake currently trailing the visitors by one. And period number two officially underway. Puck inside of the Lakers zone. And they fail to clear it there. Gloved by Heist. That's going to lead to a quick draw inside of the Lakers zone.
Good part to the first period here.
Welcome aboard.
Hello. Tim Shinning here on board. Going to just kind of sit in a little bit during the second period. First time I've ever announced hockey, actually. Out of all the sports we've done for 10 years at LETV, first one.
Puck just chilling out front.
And right.
As they didn't wait long.
Right underneath the right arm.
Is it just my eyes, or did that one look like a deflection as well? I could swear I saw that one go off of a stick. Be interesting to see who they will credit the goal with. Either way, Lakers trail by two as that goal comes just 28 seconds into period number two. Not the start they were looking for. Well, I mean, if we're still,
big collision, three players down.
And three-fourths the team. We'll go down there, puck inside the Lakers zone. Sent out front again. Fortunately for the Lakers, they're able to break it up before that play has a chance to develop. Now deep inside of the Blade zone, played along the near board, sent back out front as that shot is blocked along the high slot area. Goaltender Heist will attempt to move it. Cross ice pass as that ends up in the Laker bench.
So already 2-0 here so far, Tom. What do you think the Lakers are missing already with just, you know, already
skaters.
Down by two?
The 6 minutes and penalties have not helped their cause here early on, that's for sure. Steele County, 1-for-3 on the power play. But, the Lakers need to stay out of the box and do a much better job of moving the puck around. I think that was key. Ooh, a nice check put on there by Hansen, number four for Forest Lake. It's been a big part of the Blades game thus far has been moving the puck around. And when you can do that successfully, your opportunities are endless. Forest Lake back to the blue line. Shot taken by number 24.
There it goes.
And just like that, a two-goal lead has been slashed in half like a Black Friday sale.
Right underneath the legs there of the Steele County Blades goalie.
Forest Lake playing part in the deflection game. Why not? Counterparts have been doing it all game long. Let's jump on board. Force Lake coming back. 1 minute. I don't know, Tim, you can do math.
That would be about a minute and 55 seconds.
Here's another opportunity for the Lakers, 3-on-2. That play is broken up. The Lakers able to hold the zone. Steele County looks for options. Go with the cross ice pass. That play is broken up inside of the neutral zone. Now both teams scrambling for possession. Inside Laker territory, it's sent out front. Number 27 for Steele County with the shot. That is broken up. Rebound given. And the Blades able to hold the zone. Lakers. That's Stewart with a cross ice pass, intercepted Play broken up by number 19 as the Lakers will clear. Just kidding. Dangerous cross-ice pass there. That's going to lead to a turnover. Steele County, nice backhand pass. Shot on net, misses wide to the left. Held in by number 24. Forest Lake needs to keep a man on number 14 at all times. A very dangerous player for Steele County. Number 14 for the Blades, that's Soren Kolstrup. Points on the year for the Blades. Forest Lake now on the move. They cross over into Blade territory. They send it out front. And Steele County able to get a stick on it, and that's all they needed to break up that play. Nice turnover. Puck just hanging around out front, back to the neutral zone where Forest Lake is forced to regroup. Dumped in by number 10, Maliak. Back to the blue line. Nice job by Maliak to keep it in. Rebound given. Puck played along the far boards inside of the Steele County zone. Tied up pretty well. Oop. And just like that, we're going to have a tripping. Hey, the puck went in first. That counts. Not so much.
Close one here. So, Tom, we only have a few more games left until the big holiday winter break. I believe two more games after this one. Is that correct? Home games, at least?
Sounds about right. I wonder if Forest Lake is ever going to get to go on the power play this game. The fourth penalty called against the Lakers. Steele County 1-for-3 thus far on the power play. The Lakers need another successful penalty kill here. Number 28, that shot is blocked before it has a chance to reach the net. Shorthanded opportunity for Forest Lake, 2-on-1. And nobody knows where the hell the puck went. Hey, he pulled it out of the net. Yes, get together, officials. Let's discuss this. Or not. Come on, get on the phone with New York. Challenge this baby. Explanation currently being given to the Forest Lake coaching staff. Looks like we're gonna have a face-off inside of the Blade zone. 1:36 remaining in the Steele County power play. Shorthanded shot taken from the blue line by number 9, Crowley. Covered up by Grounds immediately. That only takes 4 seconds off of the penalty kill for Forest Lake. However, it remains in the Steele County zone. That's a good thing. Face-off is won by the Blades, picked up by number 3 as he looks for options. Dangerous cross-ice pass in front of his own net. Forest Lake forced to regroup deep inside of their own zone. And now vice versa with the Blades as they have numbers. Nice, a move put on by number 14. Wow. Fortunately, nothing came of it. They are able to hold the zone. Now 53 seconds remaining in power play number 4. Dangerous shot taken from the high slot area. And that rebound ends up in the back of the net and gives the Steele County Blades another 2-goal lead. Goal number 3 coming at 5 minute 35 seconds, and that is their second power play goal. Yuck. I have an idea. Let's call a penalty on the opposition. That one flung into the Lakers zone, picked up by number 26. And Forest Lake again struggling to clear outside of their own zone. Held in by number 6 for Steele County. Able to clear it there. That one's going to make it all the way down into the hands of goaltender Grounds. 14 minutes left to go here in period number 1. Steele County leading by 2 goals. This is meeting number 1 between these two teams. Game number 21 on the season for Forest Lake. This is game number 14 for Steele County.
Looks like a penalty actually now for your Steele County Blades. There you go, Tom, you got one.
Hey, look at that.
Did not see what it was for, but.
You guys keep telling me to stop complaining.
For slashing, that would be 2 minutes.
So a power play here for Forest Lake, their first of the night. Back to the blue line, number 28 with the shot. Deflected into the back of the net. Booyah! And 16 seconds into their first power play with authority. Forest Lake now trailing by just 1.
That was off the front of the skate in the air and landed behind him.
That was like slow motion. I saw that coming. Of course, I said nothing because I really didn't see it coming. I was just hoping.
You got to think, though, 4 points between these two teams scored in the last few minutes.
Yeah, this is going to be an exciting second and third period.
Everyone's stepping up their offense right now.
But it starts with the puck. Forest Lake at center ice. Sent into the opposition zone. Played by the goaltender Grounds for Steele County. Now played off of the near boards as that one is going to trickle all the way down to Never Ever Land. That's going to lead to a icing call, face-off inside the blade zone. 13:11 left to go here in period number 2. And it's been an exciting period thus far, huh, Tim?
Definitely has been. We're going to get another face-off here.
Lollier on the draw for Forest Lake. Steele County will win the face-off. As they attempt to clear it out, they don't. Quick shot taken by number 7, Lollier. Grounds, no problem with that. Shot count continuing to increase for both of these teams. Forest Lake, currently 18 shots on net. Steele County with 19. Face off inside of the blade zone. One by 4, Slake sent back to the blue line. Again, a one-timer taken by number 19, Brophy.
Forest Lake getting quite a few more shots on goal this period.
There definitely has been a shift in momentum. You can feel it. Forest Lake struggling to move the puck around in the first half of the game, but it looks as if they may have turned it around here. Another faceoff inside of the opposition zone. Faceoff is won by the Lakers. Doesn't look like it, but it was. Cross ice pass to number 9. Here's an opportunity for Steele County. What a move.
right behind the left leg.
That was very Crosby-ish.
Yeah.
Wow.
2-4 now, the score.
And just like that, the Forest Lake Sports Center has gone down a couple amps.
So now, Tom, I'm the one who has to update all of these graphics and posts.
Have fun.
All of these little graphics you see up in the left corner, I'm the one who have to, I have to keep creating more graphics every time someone scores, or is this going to be a high point game?
Just remember, I have not written down a single note all game long. It's all right. I heard you guys have it really easy in post.
Oh, yeah.
12:43 left to go here in period number two. The Lakers now trailing by 2 goals. Played off of the far side boards. Played inside of the neutral zone. Sent deep inside of the Lakers zone. Played by the Forest Lake goaltender. Back to that blue line for Steel County has been a big thorn in the side of the Lakers here tonight. Wow.
Went through a few players there and off the pads of the goalie.
They got a stick on it. Fortunately for the Lakers, they were able to break it up. That's another big part of the Blades game is they are, I don't know how to explain it. I was gonna say they're good off their skates, but that doesn't sound good. Nice kick save by Heiss. Keep this a 2-goal game. We don't need that lead to get any bigger for Steel County. But no, they're able to, you know, leap and grab the puck out of midair. That's not an easy feat to do. Here's an opportunity for Forest Lake, a 2-on-2. Wow.
That was
nice open ice check. Oh, thank you. I don't know why the whistle was blown. Oh.
These two down here on the right-hand side.
Keller for the dance. Oh. And it looks like the gloves are going to remain on the hands as for now, but we still may be getting a couple penalties here.
Yep. 16 for Forest Lake,
yeah,
and 5.
Coincidentals given. Should remain 5-on-5. Either way, an excellent time to blow the whistle as Steel County was about to come down with a 2-on-1. We have a Laker leaving the ice. I didn't see anything that got too out of hand that would warrant a game ejection. Did you, Tim?
I am not sure. It looks like one of the assistant coaches running after him over there. Not sure what that's all about.
We will try and keep you updated as information comes through. See?
Once again.
Michael Jordan over there. Trying to count the skaters. Is it 5-on-5 or 4-on-4? Stop moving! Nice touch by number 14. Prevented a huge opportunity. Almost got his head taken off for it, but God bless him. And another whistle. I have no...
Looks like it's on Steel County, number 6. Not sure what that was for, maybe.
Gotta be a delayed offsides or a high sticking or something.
Oh. Doesn't look like anything major.
5-on-5, hockey will continue. 10:26 left to play here in period number 2. Lakers trailing the visiting Steel County Blades. 4-2, maybe 4-3, nope. Either way, it's going to lead to another faceoff inside of the Steele County zone. Faceoff won by the Blades. Puck played along the near boards. Nearly held in by number 7, Lallier. We've got a race. Yeah, buddy.
In the top right corner, Lakers gets another point here.
Holy moly, that one went past your goalie. A one-goal lead for the Steele County Blades. I think Forest Lake's going to come back and take this thing.
They very well can. What is Forest Lake at so far this season? I'm not even completely sure.
That's a good question, wins. Tim. Forest Lake currently sitting in the fourth spot in the Elite Midwest with a record of 9-8-3, a total of 21 points. Steele County right behind us in fifth place with 17 points and a record of 8-4-1. Another shot taken on net. This has, this may have lit a fire under these boys' ass. Big opportunity out front. Pulls the goaltender out of position. Unfortunately, the Lakers cannot gain control in time. And it looks like play will be whistled dead as the net comes off of its moorings. 9:21 left to go here in period number 2. Forest Lake 3, Steele County 4. And buckle up, fans. It's going to get a lot bumpier than this. These two teams will be playing in 4 straight games. So
I know they're here once again tomorrow. Then did they go on the road with them?
Yes. Then next weekend there will be 2 games against Steele County at Steele County. Again, Saturday and Sunday. Hard to believe that game number 21 for the Lakers here tonight, and this is the first time that these two teams have met, and we're almost halfway through the 2016-17 regular season. Yeah, take a seat. Forest Lake inside of their own zone. Nice job by 14. Here could be a 2-on-1 for Forest Lake. Excellent job by number 29, the defender for Steele County. And we may have boxing coming up for you. And in the red corner.
Yeah.
Hailing out of Blaine, Minnesota, number 29. Southpaw.
They were hitting a few times back and forth.
Yeah, I counted at least 3 slashes.
Doesn't look like any penalties, though.
That's because it's just hockey.
There you go.
That's a part of the game. Where else can you hit someone with a stick and not get in trouble? God bless this game. Ah, the center's being reprimanded. Steele County with the flip and another Jordan-esque grab out of midair by number 29. This must be the Steele County basketball team in the offseason.
Yeah.
Picked up by Forest Lake. Lakers with the clear as it trickles deep into Blade territory. They are forced to play it along the near boards. Lakers unable to hold the zone. A 3-on-2, potentially a pad save,
shot.
But the puck just sitting there. No goal. That net came off of the moorings before the puck crossed the line, I believe.
It definitely looked that way.
I would have to believe there's more effective way of keeping the nets secure. because this just doesn't seem to be working too well.
Not tonight.
Looks like they're going to spot this inside of the Lakers zone. 7:47 left to play here in the second period. Forest Lake trailing by one goal. They were down by as many as two. And currently a meeting of the minds taking place. And they're going to bring the faceoff just outside of the Lakers zone. Looks like Stewart will take the draw for Forest Lake. Face off won by the Lakers. Stewart on the move.
Shot.
Quick wrist shot.
Nothing.
Steele County now threatening as they carry it over into Laker territory. Sent back to the blue line. Blades unable to hold. They do gain possession as they will regroup and dump it into the Lakers zone. Picked up by number 19. Stewart. Quick backhand. That is scooped up by Grounds. We'll have a faceoff inside the Blade zone. 7:05. Forest Lake currently with 23 shots on net. Likewise with the Blades. Only difference, they have one more goal. Hard to say who won that faceoff. Back to the blue line, and he did hold the zone. Nice cycle by the Blades. Cross-ice pass is disrupted. Wow, what a hit put on. 13 on 13 crime. Play is whistled dead, 6:36. I believe high sticking is the call. That's going to lead to a faceoff just outside of the Forest Lake zone. Faceoff won by the Blades. Cross ice pass is going to trickle all the way down into Laker territory for an icing. That's cake.
I love cake.
He's going the distance. Back to the blue line. Kick saved by Grounds. Nice drop pass to Hansen. Hansen looking for the tip. Back to the blue line. Hansen again with the shot. Excellent placement. Unfortunately, nobody home for Forest Lake in front of that Steele County goaltender. Sent back around to Hansen. We'll send it right out front. Again, nobody home. Off of the skate of number 14, back into the Steele County zone it goes. Out of the neutral zone into Laker territory, a kick save by Heiss. Lakers now with possession as they look to regroup inside of their own zone. Looks like icing is waved off. Puck now played along the far boards. And that one, obviously, offsides. Give Crowley credit for trying to sneak that pass, but with the official right there, all eyes on me, says Tupac.
Huh.
Lollier on the draw for Forest Lake. Faceoff just outside of the blade zone. Flipped up. Steele County on the move. Lollier loses his stick. Cross ice pass. Lollier with his stick. Sent back around to number 10. Deflected. And another whistle will kill the play with 4:35.
Did not see what that one was for.
Neither did I. Starting to think they're just testing their whistles.
That net did not move. That referee went up and shook it, and it didn't move again. So
they just want attention.
I see.
Face off inside of the blade zone. Back to the blue line. Hansen with a quick wrister. And even with the deflect, grounds no problem covering that up. Oh no, don't play this song. Hurry up, get the face up. Ugh! A 2-on-1 opportunity for Steele County. Nice job by the Lakers defenders to get back and break it up. Cross ice pass by Steele County there. Back to the blue line. Nice play set up by the Blades. Shot off the goaltender's mask before play being whistled dead yet again with 4:06. I guess I'm a little curious as to why play was whistled dead again. Can only guess it was high sticking or something, I don't know. Face off won by the Blades. Shot is deflected before it had a chance to reach the net. Now under 4 minutes left to play here in period number two. Little give and go. Steele County now on the move. Potential 3-on-3, and that is scooped up by the goaltender for Forest Lake. 3:32. Faceoff won by the Blades inside of the Lakers zone. Quick shot taken by number 25. That's going to miss wide right. Steele County will hang on to possession. Just over 3 minutes now left to play here in period number three. They're going to go back to the blue line. Didn't get everything he wanted to on that shot, but look at him move the puck around here again. Play is broken up, and now it's Forest Lake causing trouble inside of the neutral zone. Cross ice pass. And that's going to send a fan to the emergency room. Thanks for stopping by. 2:41 left to go here in the second period. Forest Lake trailing by one.
That hit the floor in the back here.
Yes, I was kidding. Everybody's all right.
Everyone's good.
Face off just outside. I keep wanting to call him San Antonio. Steele County, not San Antonio. I don't even know where I get San Antonio. Dangerous cross ice pass there by Steele County. It paid off though. sent into the Lakers zone. Held in by Steele County. 14 with a drop pass out front. And a nice job by Heisch to take away the angle. A 3-on-2 opportunity here for Forest Lake. Quick shot taken, just misses wide right. An opportunity out front, a quick shot taken, and guess what? Play whistle dead. That's not very nice.
Oh, and some more behind them.
You're not going to make friends that way.
Similar to that last game we were at, where it was the Blaine. That was an entire team-on-team scuffle we saw last time. Nothing like that tonight.
God, I love hockey. Face off inside of the Steele County zone. 1:49 left up on the clock. See if the Lakers can tie this set before heading into the locker room for intermission 2. Sent deep into the Lakers zone. Played along the far boards. Covered up by Grounds, a goaltender for Steele County. Now a minute 18 left in the second period. Forest Lake with 26 shots on net. Steele County not far behind with 25. Stewart on the draw for Forest Lake. Held in by number 3. Now just 1 minute left to go here in the second period. Played along the near boards, sent back to the blue line. Hansen with a quick shot. Unfortunately, that's going to come out to the neutral zone where Forest Lake will be forced to regroup. And yeah, don't worry about the checking from behind call yeah. that you didn't call. Uh-oh, there's an opportunity.
Oh.
Rebound.
Oh.
There it is. Oh! Why are you blowing a whistle? Seriously.
Not sure what the whistle
Unless
was for.
Unless this is a penalty, the net is obviously not off of its moorings. Bleh. 26.3 seconds. Stewart on the draw for Forest Lake. Back to the blue line. Played along the near board. Sent out front. Pass intercepted. And that will be sent all the way down for icing. And that's going to lead to another faceoff. Forest Lake with 13.7 seconds. Left to tie this up here in period number 2. Otherwise, going to be all period number 3. Faceoff won by the Lakers. Sent back to Hansen. Hansen with the shot on net. Shot is deflected before it reaches its target. Played by the goaltender Heiss. And that's going to do it for period number 2. We've seen quite a bit of action this period.
We definitely have. What is that? Would that be 6 points put up on the board between the two teams? They're getting a little bit rougher with each other, too, and I think Forest Lake's going to have to be pretty strong coming out of the gate this next period in order to try to capitalize on a win here tonight.
Yeah, I would expect the physical play to continue to increase. Tomorrow is going to be really interesting. But for now, I guess we're going to have to go to commercial break. Don't go anywhere. Period number 3 coming up next. Forest Lake 3, Steele County 4.
Morning, Gary. We are GetSchooled.com. You want a college education, don't you?
You know you do.
Yeah, but I don't know where to start. That's why we're here. We're free, handsome.
Oh, I think we're breathtaking.
And here to guide you through every step of the way, starting with attendance. Gary, financial aid forms.
Biology homework, G. I got this.
Is that Bran? Colleges love extracurricular activities.
Chess really isn't my thing.
I got this. Doesn't matter. Go ahead. Picking a college, man. You and us go together like tacos and Tuesday.
And I love tacos.
Welcome back. Period number three officially underway here at the Forest Lake Sports Center. And in case you missed the first two, it is Forest Lake trailing to the visiting Steele County Blades by one goal. Has been a very interesting game, to say the least. And we certainly expect nothing less here in the third period. Fast forward to tomorrow at 5:30 p.m. Same thing. These two teams will meet again right back here at the Forest Lake Sports Center for game number two of their six-game series.
Did you say 4:30 or 5:30?
5:30.
It's 4:30, I believe. Don't be late.
That's why tonight's schedule was entered as 8:30 because it's actually 7:30. Yeah, I was wondering about that. Conflicting schedules. I was just going to show up at 5 and call it even.
There you go.
Face-off inside of the Forest Lake zone. Looks like Stewart on the draw for the Lakers. Face-off won by Forest Lake. They're able to clear the zone. Picked up by number 9 for Steele County as he will cross over into Laker territory. A man out front, number 25, another one. They go back to the blue line. Shot taken, reaches the net. Forest Lake with the clear. As the Blades will send it right back in. Now 18:40 left to play here in the third period. Forest Lake trailing by one.
Quite a few bench changes already from the Steele County Blades, four times. We're not even a minute and a half in yet.
Yep, definitely trying to keep fresh legs out on the ice, especially here in the last period. Both teams trying to end a losing streak. Forest Lake riding the wave of a four game, and Steele County losing two in a row. Back to the blue line. That shot is blocked well before it reaches its target. Puck played along the near boards inside of the neutral zone. Eventually reaches Steele County territory, and now Forest Lake will be forced to regroup inside of their own zone. Sent back in Laker territory. Nifty little shot taken by number 13.
And held on by Forest Lake.
Not the whole community, but the goaltender. Face off inside the Lakers zone. Wilson on the draw for Forest Lake. That shot will miss wide left. Played by the Blades. Uh-oh. And they nearly knock it into their own net. Imagine that. The net came off of its moorings yet again. Oh, shocker.
And looks like two of the steel Blades fell down pretty hard here. 27, a little bit slow to get up.
What an original name for a hockey team, Blades.
Steel Coney Blades.
You know, because they have blades on their skates. I get it.
Oh, I thought it was from the movie Blades of Glory.
Or the old Nintendo game. What was that?
I don't know.
I don't know.
What's Nintendo, Tom? I'm too old. You're too old. Did you finally get your new NES?
Shut up.
Take that.
No, I haven't yet.
Back to hockey here.
Wilson on the draw for Forest Lake. Crowley unable to hold the zone, and now Steele County with numbers. Oh. What a setup.
Wow.
You're going to go big. I mean, that was by the books. Wow. Just an amazing setup. Not much you can do with that.
I do not think the goalie saw that player out to his right side. And that was a quick shot.
Steele County, one of those teams that prides themselves on puck movement. Sent back around on the near side. Disrupted by number 3. Yep, expect physical play to increase here in the third. And like I said earlier, these two teams play 4 straight games. So this is going to be a bumpy ride, to say the least.
Yeah, this is tomorrow, this could definitely amp up, that's for sure.
Tomorrow, I don't even think they're going to bring the puck and sticks out. They're just going to let them fight all game long. It's like 16:49 left to play in the third. Faceoff inside of the Steele County zone. A quick shot on net taken by number 23, Fladebo, for Forest Lake.
I mean, this is what Forest Lake needs to do. They need to be quite aggressive right now. I mean, now we're down by 2 points. We saw that against Blaine. They were down going into the third period. They were able to be aggressive, and they eventually won after a shootout.
Yes.
The last home game.
Never count this Laker team out. They can come back. I mean, literally just like that. Inside of the Blade zone, along the near boards, carried out to the neutral zone. Hansen will send it back to Fladebo as they attempt to clear it out of their own zone. They do. That's going to be missed, and icing is the call. 16:09 left to go here in period number 3. Again, you're watching Lakes Area Community Television. I am Thomas Glenn. To my right, my producer and good friend, Tim Shingen.
Well,
welcome.
That's me. Once again, I have to edit this show, remember? And all these high points makes editing so difficult, let alone trying to fix all of Tom's mistakes.
That in itself can be a task. Uh-oh. Nice job by the Laker goaltender to stay sharp.
So as the whistle's blown here, Tom, let's kind of talk a little bit about Forest Lake High School sports coming up here. We're doing full seasons of all home games for boys and girls soccer, boys and girls basketball this year.
Interesting. I just put in my 2-week notice.
No, that's not good.
No, I am looking forward to it. I love this time of year. Both basketball and multiple hockey teams. And a possible 2-on-1 for Forest Lake. Just kidding. Played along the far boards. Lallier. Tough angled shot. That is gloved by goaltender for Steele County, Grounds. Like coffee grounds?
Yeah.
Okay. Face off inside of the Steele County zone. Eventually trickles out to neutral ice.
Wow,
ouch.
That's right in the chest. And 25 will be skating off there as goalie holds on to it.
Did he take that off the shin or the chest?
I thought it was the chest. I might be wrong.
I mean, these guys are pretty well covered as far as equipment goes, but there are these little gaps in between, and you take a shot anywhere in between there. And
that's why you always get gap coverage.
Just walk away now. That was good. Stewart on the draw for Forest Lake. Steele County will win the faceoff. Hey, look at that. We can take it out of the air, too. Steele County on the move. Cross ice pass to number 24, who gets a quick shot off. Scooped up by Heiss. Will lead to a faceoff inside of the Lakers zone now. Under 15 minutes left to play here in period number three. Forest Lake needs to get back on the board and do it soon. Faceoff is won by the Lakers as they cross over, carry it into Blade territory. Cycled around, nobody home for the Blades. Well, if you let them, there is, and they did. Sent back into the corner, played by 14. Off of the glass, into neutral ice. Stewart. Daly out front, but that pass is broken up before it has a chance to reach his stick. The Lakers will be forced to regroup inside of their own zone. Off of the stick of Daly, picked up by Stewart. Tries to get a shot off. Yep. Intensity definitely picking up here in the third. Nice turnaround by Forest Lake, a two-on-two opportunity. And that play is broken up.
And some more hits.
Well, you stick around with the puck and they're gonna eventually take it away. Get it?
I do get it. Did you say something? No, it actually looked like one of the players from Steele County tried to dump one of the Lakers over the bench.
From the blue line, that shot misses wide left. Nearly held in, but Steele County will be forced to check, and I think they're going to get called for offsides very shortly here if that puck does not. Yep. Is Lollier going to get called for an elbow? Nope. Number 29 for the Blades was a bad boy, and we'll go sit in the bad boy box for 2 minutes and think about what he did.
So you used to play hockey, Tom, and were you ever in that box before?
That was my office.
That was your office.
I think I spent more time in there than I did on our own bench. Forest Lake will win the draw, back to Daly. Daly checks options, back to the blue line. Off of the post there. And the Blades able to clear. Shot taken by number 25 as he looks for a shorthanded opportunity. Now a minute 35 remaining in second power play for Forest Lake. If they're going to come back from this two-goal deficit, needs to start here with the power play. Blades able to clear. Forest Lake will regroup in neutral. Daly with the cross ice pass. Nice job by Hansen to reach it out of midair. Still going, shot taken. And I have no idea how Grounds was able to stay with
he
that.
He was able to hold on to it, that's for sure. It's cold in here. I don't know why.
I'm very uncomfortable, and I can't say why.
Oh, okay.
That puck's going to make it out into neutral. Shot taken, but off of the shin pad of the fourth leg defender. Number 14 for the Blades is looking for help. No teammates around. Now just 33 seconds remaining in this Laker power play. I can feel it. This is it.
So as we're seeing the Steele County Blades often, you know, changing players often, is there any benefit to Forest Lake during that time when that happens?
It all depends. You know, it's a lot of it is luck. If they can cough up the puck at the right time and catch the opposition making a change, absolutely, they can take advantage of it. But it's one of those things, you know, you just, it has to happen at the right time. Steele County now back to full strength, 5-on-5 hockey, 10:53. There's a turnover, Forest Lake with a 3-on-2. And that shot sails over the goaltender's head. Back into Laker territory. Crowley looks for a cross-ice pass, sees nothing. Decides to carry it up the ice, finds number 6, and that's dumped into the Blade zone. Played along the far side. Picked up by number 20. Wow. Come on, use your points. Get it back to the blue line. Both teams fighting hard down in the near side corner. Eventually, it's number 5 for the Blades who walks away with it. And now it's Steele County struggling to carry it outside of their zone. Sends it out front. Nobody home for Forest Lake. And Steele County finally able to clear. But not for long. Cross ice pass to Crowley. Kind of gets corkscrewed into the ice with that one as the Blades send it into neutral ice, now into Laker territory. Flipped out, and that should be icing. Icing is the call, and that will result in a faceoff inside of the Lakers zone. Forest Lake with 31 shots on net. Steele County with 33. What needs to happen in the next 9 minutes, 22 seconds for Forest Lake to win this thing?
They need to get at least 3 more points. And that's just payback, because how many times have I said that exact same question?
I should have seen that
over
coming.
Over the years. But anyways, yeah, it's Forest Lake's playing aggressive. I mean, both teams have been strong on offense all night, and I think both of them have been somewhat weak on defense, which is why we are kind of seeing a fairly high point game going into the third period here.
Let me translate that for you at home. In other words, Tim has no idea what the hell he's talking
about. That's mainly I try to sound
I'm just kidding.
Like I know what I'm doing.
All you have to do is read the script.
That's true. I haven't gotten to page 4. I don't know how this finishes though.
Oh, yeah, there is more information if you flip the page.
It's on the back side. Everyone misses that page.
Might as well take a look at the standings while we're waiting for the timeout. In the Elite Midwest Conference, as of now, Wisconsin Rapid River Kings sitting in the number 1 spot with 32 points. Behind them, Dell's Ducks, they got 23 points in second. Then you got Chicago Cougars, 17 games played, a record of 10-6-1. 21 points for them, tied with the Lakers. And there are more teams, but play is picked up, and it doesn't really matter. So Steele County sends it out front. Play is disrupted, and now the Lakers able to clear the zone just for a second as it's dumped right back in. Now 9 minutes remaining on the clock. Forest Lake trailing by two. They need to get to work and do it as of yesterday. Look at that, a gift. Oh my. Wow.
That was off the front of the foot from the goalie of Steele County. And
the opportunity was there.
Yep, missed opportunity for Forest Lake on that one.
And not to take anything away from either of the players, but just couldn't capitalize there. Face off inside of the, now I almost called them New Orleans. Why can't I just say Steele County? What is wrong with it? Wraparound attempt. Come on, buddy, use your points. That shot misses wide right, sent right back in by Scott. That's going to clear the blue line and end up in Laker territory. Nice cycle by the Lakers. Puck played along the near boards as Forest Lake now struggling to carry it outside. That's played off the glass and could very well. Oh, icing waved off. Looks like we may have a violation on the ice. And they are going to send. Looks like one of the blades have been busted.
Number 20.
Guilty as charged. 7:50 left to go with Forest Lake. 2 minute power play. Back to number 16, Daly for Forest Lake. See if the Lakers can put away a quick goal here. Clock down to 7:38.
Whistle blown as the Nets come undone once again. Guess the bubble gum's not sticking tonight.
I was just going to say. That's your answer for everything. Squirt water on it. Back to the blue line for Forest Lake. Hansen over to Daly. Daly looking nice setup.
Wow. Wow. Big hits there.
High sticking, yeah. Indefinite.
Yeah, for quite a few of those players.
Hey, pronounce the referee's last name.
That'll be a tough one.
I don't think any penalties are going to be assessed here.
I think it was both teams with the high stick.
Yep, that's going to move the faceoff down inside of the Lakers zone. Forest Lake on the power play for another minute and 38 seconds. They need to do something now. Faceoff won by the Blades. They're just going to try and eat some clock here. Dumped in by number 25. Looks like part of the game plan for Steele County for the rest of the game is keeping fresh legs out on the ice. Clock management, a big part of their game. Forest Lake struggling along the near side of the boards. Kick back out to the blue line to Hansen. Sent out front. One-timer by number 28. Misses wide left. And there goes the power play. Yep. We're going to have 4-on-4 with
a
slash.
That was a stick right to the chin.
That's number 14, Curtis Wilson, being sent to the box of shame. 2-minute minor for slashing. We'll have 4-on-4 hockey for 52 seconds before Forest Lake will be a skater short. Let's see if the Lakers can benefit from some open ice here, 4-on-4. The attempt back to the blue line fails. Wow, nice move. Too bad it didn't work.
You can definitely tell that these Steele County Blades are playing quite a bit of defense now. There's not
playing
been
conservative hockey at its finest.
Every single time it gets in the Forest Lake zone, they're swapping players. They're not focusing that hard on that. So, and
now,
they're doing exactly what they have. They have a 2-point lead.
Would you say that's more Trump style hockey, or is that Clinton style hockey? We're going to stay away from that one.
There you go. Good idea.
Lallier on the draw for Forest Lake. Faceoff inside of the Lakers zone. Picked up by number 4, Hansen, as he checks for options up ice. A little give and go as the Lakers are on the move, trailing by 2 here in the third. Puck played along the near boards. Steele County now full strength. Forest Lake down a skater for 1 minute and 1 second. Steele County having a pretty successful night on the power play, I'd say. Forest Lake with the clear cross-ice pass by Steele County. Carried in by number 25, left for 16. Nice flutter pass. Blockers saved by Heiss. Played along the near boards. Shot taken by 14, rebound given. Puck just chilling out front. Back to the blue line. Instead of taking the shot, looks for the tip. Sent right back in. That one deflected wide left. Steele County again moving the puck around at will. Nice save by Hansen. Here's some 2-on-2. Hansen goes around the defender, and it looks like the goaltender is now hurt for Steele County.
Ended up getting hit right. Was at least knocked down and well away from the goal, actually.
I didn't see any contact. As he brushes off those blonde locks. Sorry, we couldn't get the fans turned on to have it blowing for
exactly.
You.
Exactly.
Coach for Steele County, very upset. Shouldn't be, he dressed himself. Face off inside of the Blade zone. 4:28 left to go here in the third period. Lallier on the draw. Face off won by the Lakers, sent back in. This is going to be a very interesting 4 minutes and 20 seconds. Back to the blue line, held by Forest Lake. Thrown out front, unfortunately nobody able to get a stick on it. Sent back to the blue line. Lallier with the shot, and that is deflected up and out of play. That's going to lead to a faceoff inside of the blade zone. 4:03 left to play. Stewart to take the faceoff for Forest Lake. Ends up in the corner, sent around as Steele County will carry it into the neutral zone. Number 28 on the move unloads a quick shot, and that's deflected off of Crowley's stick. Puck now played along the far boards. Back to the blue line, held in by number 3. Quick shot taken, deflected, sent back out front. Now number 29 with a backhander off of another backhander into the back of the net.
Not what you want to see.
And that may have done it. It's going to be very hard to come back.
I think you're just going to think if they get a point every 40 seconds.
Or if the Blades just pulled their goalie for to be nice.
All right, one of the two.
Forest Lake.
From this standpoint, is Forest Lake, are they going to be challenging harder? Can they challenge even harder?
Trailing by this much with just 3 minutes remaining in the game, this is typically when, and I'm not saying that Forest Lake is a dirty team or anything like that, but this is typically where it really starts to become more of a physical game. When you kind of, obviously no player ever gives up, but you have to realize at a certain point your chances of winning are not looking good. They kind of reconcile that with themselves and just take it out on the opposition.
Like you said, 3 more games coming up against this team, and these players, I mean, they're quite even.
Yeah, it's not like
performance style.
It's not like these guys are going to get together and go out for tea and crumpets after the game today. Wow.
Big save.
Absolutely. That was a huge save by the Laker goaltender. Two minutes, 16 seconds. Please get this song off right now. Back to the blue line. Held in by number 5. Again, quick shot taken. And the Blades able to hold the zone. Another one, and you could see that coming a mile away.
It bounced off the ice just over the pads for Forest Lake.
This Steele County team, amazing stick work, seriously. Not to take anything away from the Laker organization, but these boys showed up to play tonight. They have been moving the puck around at will all night long. They're just playing better overall heads-up hockey. I mean, that's what it comes down to. Hopefully Forest Lake can write off this game, put it in the past, come back here tomorrow and give it to them. Again, thrown out front. Yeah, with a minute 28, trailing by 4, I don't recommend it to anybody in the game, but I would just start throwing punches.
Now I see why you say that your penalty box was your office.
Cycle, Forest Lake. I don't know, I just saw a stick go flying out of nowhere. Here's an opportunity for the Lakers. Crowley.
Off the shin. Less than a minute left here.
Picked up inside of the neutral zone. Broken up by a bodiless stick just hanging out on the boards. Here's an opportunity for Wilson, and he is taken off the play by two of the Steele County defenders as they clear it.
35 and seconds left.
3-on-3. Nice steal by number 26. Come on, bring out the money puck. Isn't that worth like 5 goals if you get the money puck in?
I believe so.
Any chance of 4 goals in 11 seconds? Or at least one. Come on, for Shingen.
And that's going to be the end of the game. A little bit of a scuffle at the end, but I think that's just going to be a preview for tomorrow night.
Yeah, expect an explosive game here at the Forest Lake Sports Center tomorrow. That game gets underway at 4:30, even though my schedule says 5:30. It's 4:30.
It will be 4:30. So as we kind of look at a preview now for tomorrow, I mean, how does Forest Lake put this behind them and move forward? As a coach, what do you want to tell your players?
Just exactly that. You know, they'll go into the locker room. He'll tell them, great performance. Get your head out of your ass. Come back tomorrow and let's do it again.
There you go.
Got to put it behind you.
Yep, so one more game here, and then they're off to the Steele County Blades Arena.
On the road for two more games.
And we're back here the first week of December, and that is it for the 2016 year. As they have a nice long holiday break, we'll be back then in January. So we'll see you again here tomorrow night at the Forest Lake High School Sports Center, Lake Scheidel Arena.
This has been a production of Lakes Area Community Television. Thanks for watching.